Our planet, which is also known as blue planet due to high amount of water, is the only planet known to us which has life. And whenever there is search for life on other planets, one thing that our scientists always look for is the presence of water. Water is a basic element for survival of any life form. So it is obvious that we humans too depend on water for our survival. You can easily find articles and videos about ill effects of not drinking enough water. Sometimes, especially in summer, our water intake increases because of quick dehydration. So parents think that they should provide some extra water to their babies. While drinking ample amount of water is good for adults, it can be deadly for newborn babies. So why is the life-giving water deadly for newborns? And why should you give only breast milk to your babies who are below the age of 6 months? Today we are going to dwell upon these topics. So stick with us throughout the video. First of all, you should know that breast milk is the best option when it comes to dietary needs of infants. World Health Organization recommends to feed your children only breast milk until they attain the age of 6 months. It not only provides proteins, carbohydrates, and fats, but it also gives essential vitamins, minerals, digestive enzymes, and hormones to your babies. As the immune system is not developed in babies, it protects them from pathogens and infections by supplying antibodies and lymphocytes. So it is better than any milk formula available in market. Now let's move towards the question of giving water to babies. You see, everyone's kidney have a limit to how much water they can handle. And when the water consumption increases beyond this level, the excess water will back up into your bloodstream where it dilutes the salt or sodium present in your blood. And when the concentration of sodium decreases too much, you are at risk of a condition known as hyponatremia. It happens when your cells try to return to normal level by absorbing the extra water. And in this process, they swell up like water balloon. This results into complications like confusion, vomiting, and muscle spasm. If you keep drinking more and more water, then the cells in the brain will also start to swell up, which builds up pressure inside your skull. This can lead to seizures, brain damage, paralysis, and in severe cases, death. But don't worry, dying from water intoxication is extremely hard for a full-grown human, as an adult would have to drink 2.5 to 5 gallons every few hours to reach that point. But for newborns, it's a different story. While an average healthy adult is made up of 55 to 60% water, average baby on the other hand is roughly 75% water. On top of that, their kidneys are about half the size of an adult's and it's really hard for them to hold additional water. So even few sips of water ends up in the circulatory system, where it dilutes their blood and increases the water content by 7 to 8%. In this way, they reach to the condition of hyponatremia really fast and it can be deadly for them. But it's not just drinking straight water that poses a threat. In fact, most cases of water intoxication in infants don't even involve a glass of water. A common mistake is when people dilute the milk formula too much, or when parents dunk their infants up and down in a swimming pool or bathtub. And in this process, the infant gulps in too much water. These are the major reasons behind water intoxication. And in such cases, you should take them to hospital immediately. But it will be wise to avoid this condition altogether. So give them water only after they reach the age of 6 months. Around this age, some baby teeth also start popping up. To know more about the baby teeth, don't forget to watch this video. And for more interesting videos, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon.